nice. The mobile lab's back from the garage. I see they didn't put on the semi-erotic mud flaps I suggested.
Can we get on with it?
Then ask her why she tries to scratch me when I pet her. Does she hate me? I do everything for her.
You know, Ray, this is highly experimental. There's no guarantee you'll come out alive.
What do I care?
Anyway, Director Bullock, I have to take off early today. My kids are leaving for the summer.
Uh-oh. This is how it starts. Ruth and I were happily married for 25 years. But when the kids left for college, we sat down to dinner one night and boom!
It's true. No one wants to eat lunch with you.
Well, even if I am boring, Francine will never find out. I've got an ace in the hole.
All right, Ray, you're going into the cat's mind in 3, 2...
If anyone needs me, I'll be living in a tree protesting logging.
No one needs you.
I can't believe my babies are leaving for the whole summer!
Hit it, hit it, hit it!
Getting to know each other all over again.
Well, that sounds great, Francine, but I think you're forgetting about... the madman we hide in the attic. He requires our constant attention. Sorry, honey.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Damn it! Hey, F-bombs!
Roger, I see you're busy, but I was thinking it's time I teach you how to do some stuff on your own.
I'm gonna be Colton Lansington, a renegade space cop who struggles to keep his bipolar disorder in check.
Okay, Colton. You just had a busy space day, and now you'd like to cool down with some intergalactic iced tea.
Checking out my pow-pow. Continue. What up, Dink?
Cleaning up after Roger again? Did he have another ticker tape parade because the deli finally named a sandwich after him?
Actually, Stan...
I got problems, Fish. Francine wants to spend the summer alone, just the two of us.
Yeah! You're going to be sexing!
I knew the kids couldn't be my buffer forever, but Roger was my ace in the hole. If he learns how to take care of himself, it'll just be me and Francine.
That's why you're stressed?
You're right! What am I thinking? Roger's an idiot! He can't take care of himself, he's like a baby! Or Africa!
Well, looky, looky. Seems we got ourselves a cabin of bunk boobs next door. I'm gonna freshen up, then make with the introduces.
You're just gonna walk right up to those girls?
Snotters, this is camp! But most people know me for my niçoise salad.
I'm Leo. I like making love with the lights on.
Geeks!
Get them! Yeah!
Stan, I have a surprise for you. You know, I had been training Roger to be more self-sufficient. Well, guess what he did this afternoon? He moved out! The cable's out, and I just got my period, so there's nothing to do but talk and talk and talk.
We can't. We have to go visit Roger. I got him a housewarming gift. This is not from the both of us.
Leave it. We're here 2 minutes, and already we're branded as nerds. I can't even wear my new sandals now! No one's gonna buy it!
Oh, face it, Steve. No matter where we go, we're just gonna be... losers.
Fellas, if we wanna be cool, we gotta shed these whiteys of tight and get ourselves some of those.
Oh, you're learning Spanish.
You gotta in this neighborhood if you wanna read the McDonald's billboards.
This is for you.
All right. Well, why don't I give you the tour? I got a job at Colonial Pet Store.
You? Working?
Francine, pour yourself a drink. Stan and I need to talk. I heard what you said. That I couldn't do anything on my own. Well, look around, jerk. It's all mine. Miss my Dana Carvey impersonations? Well, it's too late, Stan. I'm self-sufficient now. Get used to it. I don't want my rug to smell like smoke.
Stan, let's go home. Roger has a lot of unpacking to do.
No, I'm sure Roger wants us to stay for dinner. That is, unless he's incapable of making a meal.
I hid him in the fridge for when the Cholos come back. And they will be back. I gave the biggest one a key.
Wow. We're finally alone together.
What's happening?
You fell asleep at Roger's after you asked him to count to a million. We couldn't wake you up, so I carried you to the car.
We were wrong, Fish. Roger's moved out and he's completely independent. What am I gonna do?
Ask him to come back.
Yeah, I'll force him back.
You monster! I'll tell on you!
What am I doing?
No!
Roger, what are you doing here?
Stan invited me for dinner. He misses me. Oh, I brought you this. Tag, you're it.
Stan, you miss Roger. That's so sweet. To Roger's independence.
Oh, I feel awful.
Ray, I read your report from your time spent inside Buffy's brain. Very comprehensive. Well done. Buffy, I understand you think I smell weird. Now where will you sleep, you ice queen? You think you're better than me? You're not better than me. You're going to learn a hard, hard lesson.
You and me and a nice dinner rolling right into cramps and diarrhea?
What about Roger?
He's feeling better.
He's even working his afternoon shift, so we're free.
Is this food appropriate for a small dog?
Oh, ma'am, I'm not qualified to answer that. See, I only have one mouse on my name tag, which means I do stocking, lifting, and the like. You need to talk to someone with at least one dog.
Wouldn't it be something if it was true, though?
Hey, Roger! What's going on?
Not much. Just boring myself and this old broad. What's up?
Francine told me you went to work, so I thought I'd bring you a juice to keep your immune system up.
We're getting you out of that apartment and bringing you back home. You're freezing. I'll get you some blankets.
Looks like you're here to stay, Roger. This calls for a celebration.
Now, you know what? I can do it myself.
Oh my God, Stan!
Now, we just go in and tell him we want men's boxer shorts.
I see you gents are interested in buying some underwear. Or you could set them. Name's Mr. Clyde Templeton. Can I buy you boys some lunch? You wear these. Culottes.
Culottes? I don't know.
These'll make you superstars. The cool kids will carry you through the streets. Women will go hysterical. These are thank you notes from your nads.
How's he doing?
He seems to be stabilized, but he's not coming out of the coma.
Well, I guess there's nothing we can do except wait. Just the two of us. You're sure you know what you're doing?
Roger's in a coma. All I have to do is use this device to go into his brain, find him in his unconscious, and bring him over to the conscious side. It worked. I'm in Roger's mind. Now to find him. Hello, pretty bird.
I left my soda in the freezer.
Francine! Let's do some shots!
Klaus? What are you doing in here?
Stan put me in here 2 days ago.
Hey, Chocodile, watch where you're going. Francine? Francine! What are you...
Klaus told me you've been poisoning Roger just because you don't want to spend time alone with me. Because I'm not gonna be there.
Francine, wait! It's dangerous in here! Francine!
Just what you mean.
Roger's conscience.
Oh my God, you're dying of neglect.
Kill me.
It's breathtaking.
No, no, I'll never tell anyone. Your reputation is safe with me. What are tears?
Next!
Learn how to drive, you bitch!
Relax, MC Raw G. Let it go.
Are you kidding? Nobody cuts off Biggie Smalls!
He said he made this for me.
Is that true? Is that why you were afraid to be alone with me? Because you thought I'd be bored with you?
Well, yeah. So you're not gonna sit down to dinner and realize you don't want to be with me anymore?
No, honey. I know who you are, and I love you.
Oh,
my. Is it time to change already?
Yep. Or what?
The underwear works! Just like Clyde said it would!
Put them in the girls' cabin!
Free underwear salesman.
Oh, I don't think we've seen the last of him.
No, Francine.
He needs a prince.
Roger, you're in a coma. We're in your brain to help you wake up and bring you home.
Home? You mean your home?
That's right. Hey, guess who I had lunch with today? Tom Skerritt.
Oh, that's interesting.
Oh, yeah. I guess it is.